Welcome to Icenrye Geocaching Videozine Microcache Edition. We take a look at upcoming episodes of Videozine and have tips, tricks, fun items, and great caches. So sit back, relax, and enjoy Icenrye Geocaching Videozine Microcache Edition. Hi there, and welcome to Icenrye Geocaching Videozine Microcache Edition. For those of you new to the show, welcome to the family, and if you're a long-time viewer, thanks for sticking around. I appreciate your patronage. So the Microcache Edition is just a short little 5-minute weekly version that I'm putting out, and basically what it involves is I'll have little hints and little tricks and teasers from upcoming episodes. So for example, in this edition, I'm going to give you a quick tip on hydration, and I also want to show you some caching footage that I shot back in September that I'll be featuring in episode 10 of the Geocaching Videozine, which should be out by the start of April. So anyways, let's not waste any more time. Let's get right into our first 2-minute tip, hydration. Drink or die. I'm not talking about the world famous Russian hacking group. I'm talking about hydration. Water, keeping fluids in your body. Now, a lot of us when we go geocaching, it's common sense or second nature to bring along a bottle of water with you. You have to keep drinking, you have to keep hydrated. What this tip is about is sort of, we'll call it advanced water. Years ago, when I used to race mountain bikes, I'd lose approximately 5 to 10 pounds a race, and that was just in water, sweat. You go through it like crazy. And of course, you have to constantly replenish your fluids during the race, so you'd always be drinking. Well, I discovered the world of sports drinks, and at the time, the big sports drink was Gatorade, which I became a huge fan of. And I found that Gatorade not only contained water, but it also contained salts and various minerals and carbohydrates, which gave you energy and replenished not just the water, but other items, other chemicals you're losing through your sweat. Now, what I really recommend is when you go geocache, instead of just taking water, take yourself some Gatorade or pick your favorite brand of hydration drink. Now, so here's an inside tip. I found that when I was actually exerting, like when I was actually racing, I found that straight Gatorade would upset my stomach. It was almost too strong. If you've never tried Gatorade before, my favorite's, by the way, the lemon-lime flavor, which kind of tastes like a margarita without the tequila. But it is fairly salty tasting, and it does upset a lot of people's stomach. So the key to drinking Gatorade on the go, mix it 50-50 with water. And it just takes that salt content down just a little bit so it doesn't quite upset your stomach and, frankly, makes it taste slightly better. So there's your little tip for this week. If you ever go out geocaching, instead of just taking water, take your favorite rehydrating fluid, and if too straight, it's too strong, mix it 50-50 with water, your stomach will love you for it. So remember, drink or die. For this week's teaser segment, I'm going to show you some geocaching footage I shot back in September. It's a pair of local caches here in the Prince George areas by a group called Team RLC. And I actually went out one day and I found, four of their caches in one day. And I featured two of them back in episode 5, and I'm going to feature two more here in episode 10. So sit back, relax, enjoy the footage. So just a short way up the road from the Chaco Crossing is Highlands End, also by Team RLC. The cache journey takes you to this little plateau area where I'm standing, where you have an incredible view of the valley just below me. And with this time of the year being fall in the central interior with the leaves changing color, it's a gorgeous sight to see. So anyways, the cache, Highlands End, is approximately about 10-15 meters from where we're standing, and I'm sure I can find it, I hope. I've been having terrible luck lately, but that's for another show. Anyway, so it's nearby. Let's go find it. Highlands End by Team RLC. Interior showing signs of mange. New one drove away, was all arranged. Couldn't help feeling a little strange. Found her. Yeah, good find. I like it. Very nice hiding spot. Traditional geocaching hiding spot. So there you have it, a little teaser of what to look forward coming up in episode 10. And if you remember last week's episode, I got this great video from Pablo Mack on him hiding a cache in his area in Oregon. And I also have a really good geosite of the month that I'll be featuring, but I'll be teasing you on that next week. So in the meantime, and in between time, that's it. Another episode of Icenrye Geocaching Videozine Microcache Edition. So until then, Cache on.